Ladies and gentlemen, this is your awesome dude, the host of the most here. Once again, it is Team Ryan. Anyway, my lovely listeners, anyone out there on social media had a chance to listen to the podcast from earlier today? If not, smash that bell. You will get a notification from YouTube. If not, hit that like button, leave a comment, hit the subscribe, and of course, the article will be down below. You guys can leave a comment from the article. You could bash it however you want to say it, but don't give me a hard time. I'm just the messenger. I'm just trying to do my best, and hopefully people will tune in and listen to these podcasts from earlier today and from one right now. Thank you very much. Now it is time once again to discuss wrestling news, wrestling topics, and a lot of interesting topics to discuss for you. So sit back, relax, put your feet up, grab something to eat, grab something to drink. Now if you don't do nothing like that, maybe you'll chill like a villain and hear my thoughts and opinions on a certain topic, and of course the article will be down below. Let's roll with this. Now, the creating role for WWE has been very, very poorly from my point of view. It don't matter who they bring in, it sucks, because McMahon always has the final straw, and that needs to end, okay? Let the creators make their own decision. If it's good enough, then it should never anymore goes to McMahon. But of course, McMahon been there since day one, ever since he bought out his dad's company. And when he did that, things had was made it a little more interesting, you know, entertainment value, made it the WWE Attitude Era, or WF Attitude Era, my bad, and Rush and Grushin Era. So now I think McMahon is losing his touch. You guys agree? Disagree? The XFL is coming back next year in 2020. I mentioned this a couple months ago. I don't know if you guys pay attention, but I think McMahon should concentrate on the XFL and let his son of Triple H, his daughter, and of course his own son, Shane Mack, to take over the whole entire business. Probably that's not going to happen. But anywho, if you weren't aware of who Bruce Prichard is, you might need to brush up on your WWE history. There is a reason why his podcast is Something to Wrestle. I think I totally messed it up. With become so popular, he tells a lot of stories about his time in the WWE because he was there and was a creating force in a ton of keys. WWE storylines. Now it looks like Richards is back in the full time. Now you may know or may not know, he used to be Buddy Love. You know that gimmick? It was a very bizarre gimmick, but it was very awesome back in the day. Now, I read the comments about this on Facebook. They want him to come back. Brought it to love. I don't know if it'll work in this era. Maybe. Maybe not. Last time he came back, I think, was the middle of 2000s when the American Badass, and he opened his big ol' Crave. I mean, the box, and it was Burning Love. You remember that? And he had a feud with the Big Show. Okay, those were the good old days. Okay, PW Insider that WWE has hired Bruce Prichard to return to the company full-time as a part of the creating team. Now, once in a while, he does these podcasts on the WWE Network. Very, very often. You know, rarely special. So, hopefully, Bruce Prichard have some great ideas on creating team. If not, then it's going to be the same old crap. I don't know when I'm going to find out the differences. I thought when they hired Mick Foley's son. I don't know if it was a Korean team, but whatever he's doing, it did not work out. I don't know if he still worked for WWE or got fired. I'm not too sure. So hopefully, I mean, he was with WWE before, and I guess McMahon didn't like his decisions or movement, and they brought him back. And I don't know how many years he's been out of WWE, so I don't know if it's going to affect tomorrow night, or it's going to take a couple months. I'm assuming a couple months, because you got to write a script for these wrestlers and all that good stuff, you know? I miss the good old days when these wrestlers could just say whatever they want to, but they can't do it anymore because it's a PG era, and USA Network is paying WWE a lot of money for Raw. So they got stick to the script. That's kind of stupid, you know? Let the wrestlers do whatever they want to, but I understand if they go off the script, they get in trouble. Only certain wrestlers could go off the script, like The Rock, I think Austin, only certain wrestlers. But no wrestlers up today, they could do that because they will get in trouble by McMahon. You guys agree? Disagree? Do you think this would be a good move by WWE? Or do you think this would be a huge fail? We're not going to find out until probably 6 months from now or 9 months from now. I don't know if he's going to be there tomorrow night on Raw or SmackDown or on pay-per-views or just exclusive for Raw. Not too sure. It doesn't say the Korean team for Raw. It does not say the Korean team for SmackDown. It does not say a Korean team for pay-per-views. Maybe for all of it. So he's full-time. So I guess he's doing both shows. We'll see for a big difference. If this is going to be a big difference, or is it going to be the same old crap every single week. So I'm going to wrap this up here. Like, subscribe, leave a comment, hit the notification, hit the subscribe. All my other social media accounts are down below. Everyone out there, enjoy the rest of your Sunday. This is your lovely host here, DMRI. Deuces.